Welcome to this tutorial on composites design. During this video, you will acquire knowledge about the grid approach design method on CATIA 3DEXPERIENCE. Before starting the manipulations, let's talk about grid approach design. The grid design method is used to design composite parts, in the context of an assembly, by referencing structural elements to integrate into the design and analysis process. The designer must determine which structural elements to use in the grid panel, and apply composite laminates to the resulting grid definition. This preliminary design/sizing view is then turned into a detailed design by managing the Plies sequencing details and the virtual stacking before the actual creation of the Plies detailed definition. This state-of-the-art method is well suited for aeronautical structures, such as wings or fuselage barrels. It fosters composites design in assembly context by automating and optimizing the definition of the panel in the context of mating frames and stringers substructures. With this method, the user will define a grid panel, create a grid, specify a virtual stacking, and generate plies from the virtual stacking. For this tutorial, we will use this geometry, an arrow skin panel. Download the file attached to this tutorial to reproduce the steps in the video, and save it on your computer, in a directory of your choice. The file contains the 3D part, and a spreadsheet needed for the tutorial. By the end of this tutorial, you will be able to log into 3DEXPERIENCE and prepare the environment, define a grid panel, create a grid, set a virtual stacking, and finally, generate plies from the virtual stacking. Let's get started. First of all, you have to log into the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. Open the 3DEXPERIENCE login window, and enter your ID and your password. Then, click on Login. Once you have logged in, click on the compass and filter on the apps to find the composites design application. Launch it. Install the application if not done yet. We will use the CATIA composites design application to apply the grid design method to the part that you just downloaded. Once the application is opened, click on the plus button at the top right and click on Import. Import the file named aeroskinpanel.3dxml into the collaborative space of your choice, or from the directory where you saved the starting file. As soon as the import is completed, press Ctrl plus O to open the part, or right-click on the 3D part, and click on Open. Ensure that the part is open in the composites design application. The first step in a grid design approach is to create the grid panel. The grid panel defines the basic composites design parameters including its base surface, rosette, draping direction, and structural geometry. On the grid design tab of the action bar, click on the grid panel icon. This opens the panel definition window. In the dialog box, select the base or reference surface. Physically, this surface is the mold used to manufacture the composites part. Specify the draping direction indicated by the red arrow as shown. The arrow indicates the direction in which the plies will be laid onto the surface. Click on the arrow to change the direction if required. Also, select the rosette as rosette.1. Then, we will create a reference elements group. They will contain the reference elements sharing the same staggering strategy. When the grid panel is created, the first reference element group is automatically generated. Rename the first group frames. Click the Edit button to specify the ramp definition to all the elements of the frames group. Specify the ramp definition on both sides as shown and click OK. Now, we will select the reference elements for the frames group. Expand the frame's geometrical set in the specification tree, and select frame 1 to frame 5. Ensure you select the frames in the correct sequence. Selecting a reference element in the wrong sequence may lead to different cell definitions. It may not respect the expected laminate information for the respective areas. Similarly, create a second reference element group for stringers. Click Add. A new reference element group is added. Rename it Stringers. Click on Edit to specify the ramp definition. Here, we will apply the same ramp definition on both the sides of reference elements. Select the Stringers 1 to Stringers 16 as reference elements for this group. Click OK. A grid panel has been created in the geometry area, as well as in the specification tree. The second main step in this approach is the creation of a grid. On the Grid Design tab of the action bar, click on the grid icon. The grid tool uses the grid panel that we just created and generates automatically the regions from the grid panel. These individual regions are called cells and are formed by the contours of the structural elements of the grid panel. Each cell is associated with a laminate. A laminate is defined as a group of layers, which can be of different material and orientation, and for which the order of the layers may be specified, laminate of type stacking sequence or let free, laminate of type thickness law and thickness ratio. You can add laminates to each cell manually or by importing a spreadsheet containing laminate information for each cell. Please watch the grid approach with import video for details on using a spreadsheet. In the dialog box, each cell is limited by 4 reference elements. You can add, merge or edit the cells by using the buttons available in the dialog box. Let us select a few cells and associate the laminate L2 with them as shown. Observe that the laminate L2 is applied to selected cells. It means that the area belonging to selected cells will have the thickness defined by the certain laminate associated with them. The edit option lets you modify the cell name, contour, and laminate associated with the cell manually. The import-export management option available in the dialog box lets you export the grid information, modify it, and import the modified information. Browse and access the aerostructure_grid_panel.xlsx file to import, that you downloaded with the file attached to this tutorial. Click on Import. Observe that each cell gets associated with one laminate as predefined in the spreadsheet. Also, the cell gets displayed in the respective colors of the associated laminates. Hide the reference surface and grid panel to clearly visualize the grid. Currently, each cell is labeled only with a cell number. Let us click Options in the 3D Text Labels area to modify the information that we want to display. Select the options as shown in the 3D Display Options panel and observe the changes in the geometry area for each cell. Let us learn how to interpret the information from the display area. Here, cell C2 will respect the laminate L2. The area belonging to C2 will have 24 plies, and the thickness of part in this area will be 2.64 mm. Many identical cells respect the same laminates. So, click on the One Label for Identical Cells checkbox to display only one label for the identical cells instead of individual labels. Click OK in the grid definition dialog box to create the grid. A grid has now been created, combining geometry and laminate design intent. After creating the grid, virtual stacking is used to transition the preliminary design grid definition into detailed design plies that can be manufactured. This step is done by the software combining the neighboring cells covered by the same layers, the same material, and with the same orientation, to create ply sequences. Besides, Composites design rules are also integrated by the software at this step, such as symmetrically balanced, as well as full plies on external layers. Beyond the automatic generation by the software, the virtual stacking commands from the grid design section allows you to manually edit the proposed detailed design. You can manipulate the ply sequences by adding or removing the cells to or from a sequence, merging the plies into a single sequence, editing rows in the virtual stacking, changing the layup sequence, and importing stress information into the virtual stacking. You can modify the stack-up order, ply shape, and add or remove plies or sequences using this toolbar, if the part is being designed without the main stacking sequence. You can modify the stack-up order, ply shape, and add or remove plies or sequences using this toolbar, if the part is being designed without main stacking sequence. On the Grid Design tab of the action bar, click on the virtual stacking icon. A proposed virtual stacking, respecting the thicknesses defined in the grid, is displayed in the virtual stacking dialog box. Select the ply option as entity level, and the cells option as view mode. The combination of entity level and view mode is used to retrieve and view the required information. The arrow options available in the review tool lets you scan the rows and columns to highlight the information in the 2D viewer and on the part. In the virtual stacking, each row corresponds to a virtual ply and each column to a cell. All the cells covered by the ply are highlighted with the ply direction color, allowing one to view the definition of the ply. Select the first row that is ply.1 in the 2D viewer and observe that ply.1 is highlighted in the geometry area. Similarly, you can scan through all the plies using the down arrow. Switch to the sequence option as entity level and highlight the sequences randomly in the geometry area. Now, select all the sequences by clicking on the cell in the upper left corner as shown, and select the first option in the preview area to visualize the shape of the plies or sequences without previously generating them. It helps to preview the plies to be generated with each option and the result of the staggering strategy defined in the grid panel. Select the options one after the other, and carefully observe the result. Also, observe the plies design at the drop-off area. After previewing the result with all options, deselect the last selected option, and click OK. The virtual stacking has been created. Now, let's do the last step of this design methodology, creating plies from the virtual stacking. On the Grid Design tab of the action bar, click on the Plies from Virtual Stacking icon. The Plies from Virtual Stacking command from the Grid Design section allows you to create plies from the virtual stacking. The contour of the plies is based on the sequence shapes and on the initial staggering that is defined on structural elements during panel creation. Ensure that the grid virtual stacking is already selected in the dialog box. Now, you have to select an algorithm to define ply boundaries. There are three main types of algorithms. The minimum crossing method is used to create ply boundaries that avoid crossing ply ramps as much as possible, but may result in ply definitions that are larger than would be produced by the other two algorithms. Then, the minimum crossing and weight saving method creates ply boundaries that are optimized to balance both the smallest area with the minimum ramp crossings. This algorithm option typically produces the best solution for weight reduction with minimum ramp crossings. However, it creates more complex Plies boundaries that might make the part more complex and expensive to manufacture. Finally, the weight-saving method is used to create ply boundaries that cover the minimum necessary area, but may result in ply definitions that, due to their many ramp crossings, have more buildup on the ramps than would be produced by the other two algorithms. In our case, select the minimum crossing algorithm. Select backlash from the drop-off pattern drop-down list. The drop-off pattern takes the orientation of plies into account. Click OK. The plies are generated in the geometry area. Also, the stacking node is generated in the tree along with the plies group and plies. Hide the grid definition and unhide the base surface to see the plies. Observe ply drop-off or the staggered plies where the thickness of the part changes. The distance between the plies and the ramp curve generation is driven by the ramp definition that we have specified during the grid panel. You can also use the local drop-off option of the action bar to modify the plies. It is interesting to set up a drop-off pattern to better distribute the stresses at the edge of the folds, to mitigate the risks of delamination. In the grid design section of the action bar, click on the local drop-off icon. Choose a part of the grid and click on compute section. You can see in the dialog box the section with the different plies. Try to drag the plies to modify it. You can also change the pattern. Try different patterns and click on apply pattern. You can directly see the modifications in the dialog box. When you finished, click OK. This is the end of the tutorial. In this video, you learned how to log into 3DEXPERIENCE and prepare the environment, define a grid panel, create a grid, set a virtual stacking, and finally, generate plies from the virtual stacking. Don't hesitate to watch this tutorial again, and reproduce all the steps by pausing the video.